Welcome back to my channel. It's Hillary Jubilee. If you're new, we usually talk about all things manifestation, law of assumption, that type of deal. And thank you for being here. Today's video is about a TikTok that I saw recently about this girl who said her and her best friend do this practice together where to help with manifestation, if one is telling the other about some sort of thing they're really excited about or something new's popping up into their life, or they are just checking something out that they might buy or whatever, or started dating somebody new, anything that they're telling the other person about, then one will ask the other, "That all sounds amazing. Is that your dream? Is that the dream?" And this really resonated with me because it's like we settle on things so many times that it's just like, oh, this is in front of me, and I'm just gonna, like, me for what personally, for one, will just like look for the best and people especially, and always give things the benefit of the doubt. It's in front of me, get so excited about it, see the potential in it. People you're dating, whatever, you could apply this to anything though, but just literally, you could ask yourself, or if you have a manifesting bestie, you could ask them to ask you, or do this together. Is that the dream? Because if you're ignoring things that bother you or don't fit, you know, the dream, and you're just settling for something, then it's taking up space in your life and blocking you from getting the dream. And, you know, with people especially, like, if it's kind of like the same concept of fuck yes or no. Like, if it's not a fuck yes, it should be a no. If it's not like a full body, like you feel a pull towards it, you feel a full body yes towards something, then it's probably a no. There's probably something better out there for you that you just can't see at the moment, but it's there. So when we settle, it's like it's stagnant energy that's blocking us from getting the dream. So I just love that little, you know, tip, and it's just a quick video, but you could apply this to someone you're dating. Personally, I am single now, so it's like, is this the dream? Because if not, you're wasting your damn time. If you are like looking for a place to live, a house to buy, or a place to rent, oh, it has this quality, and oh, it's in this nice neighborhood. For example, my best friend Fern, her and her boyfriend are looking to buy a place, and they found a really nice place with nice lighting, like, not nice lighting, but nice big windows where the light came in, because she has plants. She has a plant, YouTube, Fern, Wild Fern. And it was a nice neighborhood, nice neighbors, nice house, everything in their budget, blah, blah, blah. But there was like a fishery next to it, and it friggin' stinks. So they decided not to buy it because it's not the dream. It's not the dream to wake up and go outside your house and have it smell like fish, okay? So, like, you could apply this to anything. You know, for me personally, like buying things, for example, I want to upgrade my kitchen table because I bought it secondhand and it has all these like cup holder rings on it. And it's like, that doesn't make me feel very abundant. It's like rickety and gross. Like, and my mom keeps sending me all of these tables and she's like, oh, how about this one? How about that? I'm like, is that the dream? No, I don't like the color of that one. I'm going to wait it out for a nice table that I actually like. So anyway, you know what is the dream? Fawain, she's the dream. Okay, that's all I have for today's video. I just wanted to get a video out because procrastinating is not the dream. So here we are. Thank you for watching. Subscribe. I love you. Bye.